Welcome to this service of evening prayer from the Book of Common Prayer on this ninth Sunday after Trinity, the 9th of August 2020, from St Mark's Church in Reigate. In this service, we include some hymns which you can sing along with. Our readings talk about King Solomon's son succeeding him and that he did not possess the same wisdom as his father. And Paul and Barnabas healing a man and being mistaken for Greek gods come to life. As you watch this service, perhaps you can join in with the hymns, with the responses, and with the Lord's Prayer. We begin by singing the hymn, Eternal Father, Strong to Save. Dearly beloved brethren, the scripture moveth us in sundry places to acknowledge and confess our manifold sins and wickedness, and that we should not dissemble nor cloak them before the face of Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, but confess them with an humble, lowly, penitent and obedient heart, to the end that we may obtain forgiveness of the same by his infinite goodness and mercy. And although we ought at all times humbly to acknowledge our sins before God, yet ought we most chiefly so to do when we assemble and meet together to render thanks for the great benefits that we have received at his hands, to set forth his most worthy praise, to hear his most holy word, and to ask those things which are requisite and necessary, as well for the body as the soul. Wherefore I pray and beseech you, as many as are here present, to accompany me with a pure heart and humble voice unto the throne of the heavenly grace, saying with me, Almighty and most merciful Father, we have erred and strayed from thy ways like lost sheep. We have followed too much the devices and desires of our own hearts. We have offended against thy holy laws. We have left undone those things which we ought to have done. And we have done those things which we ought not to have done. And there is no health in us. But thou, O Lord, have mercy upon us, miserable offenders. Spare thou them, O God, which confess their faults. Restore thou them that are penitent, according to thy promises declared unto mankind in Christ Jesus our Lord. And grant, O most merciful Father, for his sake, that we may hereafter live a godly, righteous, and sober life, to the glory of thy holy name. Amen. Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who desireth not the death of a sinner, but rather that he may turn from his wickedness and live, and hath given power and commandment to his ministers to declare and pronounce to his people, being penitent, the absolution and remission of their sins. He pardoneth and absolveth all them that truly repent and unfeignedly believe his holy gospel. Wherefore, let us beseech him to grant us true repentance and his Holy Spirit, that those things may please him which we do at this present, that the rest of our life hereafter may be pure and holy, so that at the last we may come to his eternal joy, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O Lord, open thou our lips,
and our mouth shall show forth thy praise.
O God, make speed to save us.
O Lord, make haste to help us.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Praise ye the Lord.
The Lord's name be praised.
Our appointed psalm is Psalm 86, verses 1 to 7. I will say the odd number verses. Please respond with the even number verses. Incline your ear, O Lord, and answer me, for I am poor and in misery.
Preserve my soul, for I am faithful. Save your servant, for I put my trust in you.
Be merciful to me, O Lord, for you are my God. I call upon you all the day long.
Gladden the soul of your servant, for to you, O Lord, I lift up my soul.
For you, Lord, are good and forgiving, abounding in steadfast love to all who call upon you.
Give ear, O Lord, to my prayer, and listen to the voice of my supplication.
In the day of my distress I will call upon you, for you will answer me.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The first lesson is taken from the 11th chapter of the first book of Kings. Now the rest of the acts of Solomon, and all that he did, as well as his wisdom, are they not written in the book of the Acts of Solomon? The time that Solomon reigned in Jerusalem over all Israel was 40 years. Solomon slept with his ancestors, and was buried in the city of his father David, and his son Rehoboam succeeded him. Rehoboam went to Shechem, for all Israel had come to Shechem to make him king. When Jeroboam, son of Nebat, heard of it, for he was still in Egypt where he had fled from King Solomon, Jeroboam returned from Egypt, and they sent and called him. And Jeroboam and all the assembly of Israel came and said to Rehoboam, "Your father made our yoke heavy. Now therefore lighten the hard service of your father and his heavy yoke that he placed upon us, and we will serve you." He said to them, "Go away for 3 days, then come again to me." So the people went away. Then King Rehoboam took counsel with the older men who had attended his father Solomon while he was still alive, saying, "How do you advise me to answer this people?" They answered him, "If you will be a servant to this people today and serve them, and speak good words to them when you answer them, then they will be your servants forever." But he disregarded the advice that the older men gave him, and consulted with the young men who had grown up with him and now attended him. He said to them, "What do you advise that we answer this people who have said to me, 'Lighten the yoke that your father put on us'?" The young men who had grown up with him said to him, "Thus you should say to this people who spoke to you, 'Your father made our yoke heavy, but you must lighten it for us.' Thus you should say to them, 'My little finger is thicker than my father's loins. Now, whereas my father laid on you a heavy yoke, I will add to your yoke. My father disciplined you with whips, but I will discipline you with scorpions.'" So Jeroboam and all the people came to Rehoboam the third day, as the king had said, "Come to me again the third day." The king answered the people harshly. He disregarded the advice that the older men had given him, and spoke to them according to the advice of the young men. "My father made your yoke heavy, but I will add to your yoke. My father disciplined you with whips, but I will discipline you with scorpions." So the king did not listen to the people, because it was a turn of affairs brought about by the Lord, that he might fulfil his word which the Lord had spoken by Ahijah the Shilonite to Jeroboam son of Nebat. When all Israel saw that the king would not listen to them, the people answered the king, "What shall we do we have in David? We have no inheritance in the son of Jesse. To your tents, O Israel. Look now to your own house, O David." So Israel went away to their tents, but Rehoboam reigned over the Israelites who were living in the town of Judah. When King Rehoboam sent Andoram, who was taskmaster over the forced labour, all Israel stoned him to death. King Rehoboam then hurriedly mounted his chariot to flee to Jerusalem. So Israel has been in rebellion against the house of David to this day. When all Israel heard that Jeroboam had returned, they sent and called him to the assembly and made him king over all Israel. There was no one who followed the house of David except the tribe of Judah alone. Here ends the first lesson.
Thank you. reading from the Acts of the Apostles, chapter 14, beginning at verse 8. In Lystra there was a man sitting who could not use his feet and had never walked, for he had been crippled from birth. He listened to Paul as he was speaking, and Paul, looking at him intently and seeing that he had faith to be healed, said in a loud voice, "Stand upright on your feet." And the man sprang up and began to walk. When the crowd saw what Paul had done, they shouted in the Lyconian language, "The gods have come down to us in human form." Barnabas they called Zeus, and Paul they called Hermes, because he was the chief speaker. The priest of Zeus, whose temple was just outside the city, brought oxen and garlands to the gates. He and the crowds wanted to offer sacrifice. When the apostles, Barnabas and Paul, heard of it, they tore their clothes and rushed out into the crowd, shouting, "Friends, why are you doing this? We are mortals just like you, and we bring you good news that you should turn from these worthless things to the living God, who made the heaven and the earth and the sea and all that is in them. In past generations, he allowed all the nations to follow their own ways, yet he has not left himself without a witness in doing good, giving you rains from heaven and fruitful seasons, and filling you with food and your hearts with joy." Even with these words, they scarcely restrained the crowds from offering sacrifice to them. But Jews came from there from Antioch and Iconium and won over the crowds. Then they stoned Paul and dragged him out of the city, supposing that he was dead. But when the disciples surrounded him, he got up and went into the city. The next day, he went on with Barnabas to Derbe. Here ends the second lesson.
Say together the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and sitteth on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. Lord, have mercy upon us.
Christ, have mercy upon us.
Lord, have mercy upon us.
Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive them that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
O Lord, show thy mercy upon us.
And grant us thy salvation.
O Lord, save the Queen.
And mercifully hear us when we call upon thee.
Endue thy ministers with righteousness.
And make thy chosen people joyful.
O Lord, save thy people.
And bless thine inheritance.
Give peace in our time, O Lord.
Because there is none other that fighteth for us, but only thou, O God.
O God, make clean our hearts within us.
And take not thy Holy Spirit from us.
The Collect for the Ninth Sunday after Trinity. Almighty God, who descend thy Holy Spirit to be the life and light of thy Church, open our hearts to the riches of thy grace, that we may bring forth the fruit of the Spirit in love and joy and peace. Through Jesus Christ, thy Son, our Lord. Amen.
O God, from whom all holy desires, all good counsels, and all just works do proceed, give unto thy servants that peace which the world cannot give, that both our hearts may be set to obey thy commandments, and also that by thee, we, being defended from the fear of our enemies, may pass our time in rest and quietness, through the merits of Jesus Christ our Saviour.
Amen.
Lighten our darkness, we beseech thee, O Lord, and by thy great mercy defend us from all perils and dangers of this night, for the love of thy only Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
We sing the hymn, Great is Thy Faithfulness. We are led by the choral scholars of St. Martin in the Fields.
Pastions, they fail not, as God has
Let us pray. Almighty God, the Creator and Preserver of all, we humbly beseech thee for all sorts and conditions of thy people, that thou wouldest be pleased to make thy ways known to them, thy saving grace to all nations. Lord, in thy mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for the good estate of the Catholic Church, that it may be so guided and governed by thy good Spirit, that all who profess and call themselves to be Christian may be led into the way of truth, and hold the faith in unity of spirit, in the bond of peace, and in righteousness of life. Lord, in thy mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray thee to guide and direct all who govern the nations of the world, especially our Sovereign Lady, Queen Elizabeth, and those who have set an authority over us, that we and all people may be justly and quietly governed. Lord, in thy mercy,
hear our prayer.
We commend to thy fatherly goodness all those who are afflicted or distressed, especially those for whom our prayers are desired, that it may please thee to comfort and relieve them according to their several necessities, giving them endurance under their sufferings, and a happy issue out of all their afflictions. Lord, in thy mercy,
hear our prayer.
Finally, we pray for all thy servants departed this life in thy faith and fear. Let light perpetual shine upon them, and in thy loving wisdom and almighty power, work in them the good purpose of thy perfect will. Lord, in thy mercy,
hear our prayer.
Almighty God, who has promised to hear the petitions of those who ask in thy Son's name, grant that those things which we have faithfully asked, according to thy will, may effectually be obtained, to the relief of our necessity, and to the setting forth of thy glory. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We say together the words of the grace. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, be with us all, evermore. Amen. We sing the hymn, Dear Lord and Father of Mankind.
Amen.
The peace of God, which passeth all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the love and knowledge of God and of His Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you and all those you love and pray for, this day and always. Amen.